Family and friends, welcome again to P-Roll's Creole Cuisine. I hope everybody's having a blessed day, a blessed weekend, a blessed life. So today we're going to do a little jambalaya, panini, shrimp, sausage, and chicken jambalaya.
Make mine the people. I want my funk uncut. Make my funk the people. I want to get funked up.
A little something different. This is a little healthier recipe. I use chicken, I use shrimp, I use turkey sausage to make sure it's something a little healthier for folks who want to eat a little healthier. So I'm going to walk you through the ingredients. We got a large onion chop, bell pepper chop, got protein panini, plant-based, olive oil, turkey sausage. We got some shrimp, chicken thighs. You know, I like using the chicken thighs. We got the onion, garlic powder, the Italian seasoning, the Tony's. I'm gonna use a half a cup of whipping cream. I'm gonna use some crushed tomatoes. We got garlic paste, basil paste, chicken broth, and we're gonna top it off with some Parmesan cheese. So I'm gonna show you what we're gonna do first. We're gonna start getting our chicken and shrimp all seasoned up. Okay, so we're gonna start with some Tony's, about 2 tablespoons. Got a little onion powder, garlic powder, 2 to 3 tablespoons at the most on each Italian seasoning. Everything's 2 to 3 tablespoons. I'm gonna get that incorporated in there. Get it all stirred up real good so it's the same everywhere. So in that shrimp, we got the shrimp seasoning. Let's go back. Chicken thighs, 2 to 3 tablespoons of some Tony's. 2 to 3 tablespoons of some garlic powder. 2 to 3 tablespoons of some onion powder, and 2 to 3 tablespoons of some Italian dressing. There you go, we got that incorporated, now we can start cooking. First we're gonna start by boiling the panini. Gonna get that going, that takes about 3 to 5 minutes. After that we're gonna add 2 to 3 tablespoons, maybe 4 tablespoons of olive oil, because we're going to just get that shrimp cooked up real good. Then we're going to cook the chicken, come back, get the onions and onion and the garlic paste and the bell peppers and all that good stuff going. And once we got all that incorporated with some sausage, we're going to come back, marry everything up, a little cream, cheese. You'll see. Hope it comes out good. I like this recipe because it's a healthy recipe, but it really tastes great. Still got all those good Louisiana flavors in it. So we're just gonna make this thing work. All right, let's see if we can get these shrimp going. Oh yeah, that sizzling sounds good. You know, shrimp don't take long, so we're just gonna let them get pink. Looking good, looking good. Those look good enough to eat just like that. We're gonna take them off right now because we're gonna come back and cook them a little bit longer. Make sure they cook through. Yeah, that's about 1.5 pounds of shrimp. About 1.5 pounds of shrimp. I got about 1.5 pounds of chicken thighs also. I want to add just a little bit more olive oil, because what I want to do, I want to get all that brown out of here. Get all that out of here. Get all that seasoning, get all that love. All right, time for these chicken thighs. There we go. Got the panini boiling over here. Take the panini off. Just setting the panini to the side. Let it drain. Oh, that smells good. Again, this is jambalaya panini sausage, shrimp, and chicken. A healthy version. Chicken is all brown, looking good. We're gonna take it off, put it with the shrimp. Cause all this is going back in there together. Now we're gonna add half a stick of butter. A little bit more olive oil. Gonna grit these kibbles and bits down here. We're gonna drop these onions and bell pepper. Remember, that's a large onion, one large bell pepper. Tomato paste. Garlic paste, about a tablespoon. And a half. Basil, same thing. Get that going. We're gonna cook all this at the same time, so I'm gonna add that sausage in there now. We're gonna let this cook. All right, we got the sausage, tomatoes and onions, the garlic paste, the basil cooked down. We're gonna add 14.5 ounces of tomatoes, diced tomatoes. I got the ones with the garlic and herb in it. Let that cook down. That's simmering real good. We're gonna let that simmer down for about 2 minutes. There we go. Boy, that's cooking like that. We're gonna add about half a cup. I don't measure too much, but I'm gonna measure today. We're gonna do half a cup of chicken stock. Looking good. Half a cup of whipping cream. Lactose intolerant, I'm sorry. Gonna let that cook. Gonna add a little bit more tonnage to it. And let all that marry up and cook down. Alright, we're gonna let this cook. About 5-10 minutes. Gonna get that all cooked down. Let that cook real good. Then we're gonna come back and add the shrimp and chicken in this in about 5 minutes. The panini. Let's see how we look from here now. So I got the shrimp. And the chicken going back in here, right? Looking good. Now, I made some shrimp stock. In the shrimp stock, I took the hulls from the shrimp. I used some crab, Louisiana crab ball, some shrimp ball. I used some lemon pepper, and I used a little bit of garlic paste. And I made my shrimp stock. I'm gonna put a half a cup in here to give it a little bit more flavor. I'm gonna turn the heat up and let it cook a little bit. Man, that looks good. All right. Now, I'm gonna turn the heat up only just a little bit to get it going. And then I'm gonna add the panini in. Got that panini incorporated in there. Now, the last step, folks, the last thing, and I'm gonna go ahead and top this thing off. is some good old Parmesan cheese. This is equivalent to a cup and a half, I'm sorry. I'm gonna use the whole cup and a half in here. Make it nice and cheesy. Get that stirred in there. If you want to add more cheese, you can. I think I'm adding just a little bit more Parmesan. Just a little bit more to give it a little flavor. There you go. Top it off with a little Tony, folks. That is it again. Welcome to P-Rose Creole Cuisine. We thank you for your support. We thank you for your love. Keep watching. We got more coming your way.
Make mine the people. I want my funk uncut. Make my funk the people. I want to get funked up.